Hi and welcome to Space with Sarah. A very popular question to ask an astrophysicist seems to be, is there life elsewhere? Do aliens exist? Have we been visited by aliens? One answer could be, of course there's life elsewhere. There are so many galaxies, stars, and planets. Why would Earth be so special? If it started here, it must have started elsewhere. But the truth is that we don't know. We have one data point to work with, and that is life here on Earth. We have not found life elsewhere, and equally as important, we have never been able to produce life out of non-life. The verdict on how life forms is still out. Here on Earth, the first form of life started as a single-cell organism in the very early history of the solar system. It is thought that life formed roughly 4 billion years ago, and the Earth is only 4.6 billion years old. It seems that when life could start on Earth, it did. It's pretty important to keep in mind that the human race as we know it, Homo sapiens, have only existed for 200,000 years, which is only a tiny fraction of the time that Earth has existed. So intelligent life seems to take a while to form. You can define intelligent life however you like, but we do indeed seem to be the only species who have ever explored the origin of the universe here from Earth. It's a big unknown whether or not there's life out there, but one thing that we have learned a lot about in the last decades is planets around other stars than the Sun. Maybe you remember this from a previous video. That's right, exoplanets. We also talk about how we think planets need liquid water, a rocky surface, and an atmosphere for life to start. In our lifetime, it will probably be hard to prove that there is life out there, unless we find fossil life on one of the nearby planets, for example, Mars. However, what we can do in the very near future is start probing the atmospheres of other rocky planets. We can search for rocky planets around other stars at the right distance from their host star to be able to have liquid water and probe what their atmosphere is made of. This is all a very new and active field of research. When we point a telescope to a star that has a planet orbiting it, we can analyze the light from the star alone and the light from the star with a planet in front of it. By investigating the differences between those two observations, we can figure out what the planet's atmosphere is made of. This is done by subtracting the observation of the star from the observation of the star and planet. This is not as simple as it sounds, because the star is a lot brighter than the planet, and many other technicalities. But these experiments are starting to be made. This will enable us to find atmospheres with, for example, water vapor, oxygen, ozone, and carbon dioxide, which can help us in the search for signs of life. So my answer would be, we have not found life other places than on Earth, and we might not actually prove the existence of life elsewhere in our lifetimes. But we will be able to find Earth 2.0, with the right distance from its star, and with a similar atmosphere to what we have here on Earth, if it exists. That to me is very exciting. The fact that we probably won't be able to go there anytime soon is a whole different discussion on the feasibility of interstellar travel, which I'll get into some other time. Thanks for watching Space with Sarah. If you're still curious about the universe, please subscribe to the channel. And as always, keep wondering.